Welcome to this What's the Collector presentation. I'm Paul, and today we got a Hot Wheels. We got a Hot Wheels Super Rig. We got a Target exclusive Hot Wheels Super Rig. It's the HW Bullseye's Big Rig, which retails in Target, at least my local Target, for $8.49. But when I bought it, there was a 25% off coupon on the Target app, so I got that 25% off that, so that got it down to about $6.50-ish. But I also had a $5 gift card, so I got it for about a dollar something out of pocket. It's considerably larger than their Trackstars range, which we're gonna show. We're gonna compare this once we get out of the box to the other some other rigs. It also comes with the shopping cart type car. The name escapes me because I don't collect the fantasy stuff generally. This is a minifigures such as the Ghostbusters over there, the Legos guys, those ones. They will attach to it, so we're gonna grab one. We're gonna grab a Ghostbuster and see them play around with the car. Here's the back of the packaging. It's a detachable trailer. Here's all your information if you need it. And it's a bit of a hokey thing. It's a bit of a high-priced item at the price it is. I don't know what they normally sell for, but it seems a little high to me. A lot of people seem to be dissing this online. I don't know, but I like my nostalgic stuff. I mean, I like this kind of stuff. Real world liveries. Granted, Target doesn't have any trucks that look like that. But there's your little metal bodied, plastic based shopping cart car, which is really cool. I don't know if that's particular, I don't think it's a particular scale, like, you know, whatever, but here we go with the rig. We'll look at the shopping cart first. The packaging back there, in case you're interested in seeing that. Didn't look good? That looks good. It's the aisle driver. It has the open hub 5 spokes. It's red metal. Got the Target logo on there. We're going to take Ray Stans, the creator of the Ghostbusters. A little dusty because we get dust in here. This is the Ray minifigure. The set that came with the original minifig size, the Ecto one that fits in the Ghostbusters headquarters that they made. He can ride on. You can do acrobatics if you pull them right. But that's not necessarily what we're here for. And if you didn't notice, was that his foot? Oh, if he has his back, he can take his backpack off. Oh, come on, it should. This comes off, man. I know I did this before. He can fit in here too, so he can stand here and ride while Egon pushes him around in the shopping cart. Kind of a odd scale, but whatever. It is what it is. It's an interesting addition. It could have just been the rig. But we'll take care of the Ghostbusters later. That's not what we're here for. The truck itself, the cab is metal. Everything else, except for the axles, is plastic. But as the packaging said, the trailer is removable. I don't want to break it. Take it off camera. Okay, there we go. It's gonna be easier to show. Got construction tires, sort of a futuristic looking truck in red because Target's colors are red and white. Chrome fenders, gray engine, and I'm assuming if there's an interior in there, it'd probably be part of the gray engine piece. Black base. It's actually called the Big Rig, the Rig Dog. I can read that, Rig Dog. Rolls like a dream. Rolls like a dream. Rolls like a champ. This is completely plastic. There's an opening door, which isn't realistic, but it acts as a ramp if you have. I don't know. Will they? Won't they? Have any small cars? I don't have any small cars, but we're gonna take one of these customs that I did. Custom Mustang. If they do fit in there, so that's awesome. I don't think this will fit because it's too high. Yeah, the shopping cart's unfortunately too high, but it features the Target name and logo and the Target dog Bullseye, which is their mascot. They've had forever. This snaps on here. And in an homage to Race Grooves, we're going to give it a rolling test, squeaky wheel test. No squeaky wheels. Great ratings. Roll turns like a champ. And the back, which I forgot to show you, features Bullseye in the back. So we're going to compare it to other sizes. So this is the Super Rig size in Hot Wheels. This is the Track Stars, which are considerably smaller, but they fit on the track. So you could roll this where it connects and everything through loops and curves and all manner of things. It's more the scale of what you get at your the Matchbox rigs. This is a cheap Chinese rig from the local grocery store Market Basket, which if you haven't checked in my playlist, the Nostalgic Diecast playlist, I get tons of this particular grocery store car trucks. Too many to count. But anyway, they're roughly, I'd say they're the same scale-ish. Sure, the box is a little longer, but they're roughly the same size. The wheels are bigger, but this one doesn't roll as well because it's just cheap. And then we have a vintage 1/100th scale majorette from the department store Caldor, which ironically, the Target that I bought this from used to be a Caldor. So they're gonna be very fitting if I can somehow manage them to be. Oh, good. Oh, awesome. 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 So when I display it on the shelf with the rest of the big rigs, that's how it's going to be. That is just wicked sweet. So yeah, this has been the Hot Wheels Super Rigs HW Bullseye's Big Rig and Aisle Driver review and unboxing. So if you like what you saw, click the like. Want to see more of it? Think about subscribing if you haven't already. And if you made it this far, thank you for watching. And like, comment, share, subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.